Yes, we can have life and life abundantly, and we are delivered by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, it's a wonderful thing. And if you don't know him today, I pray that you will. I pray that you do already know him. He is so wonderful and loving and gracious and faithful. His promises are so true for you and me today. And you know, this is the end of the new year, and I'm having a little celebration at my home, and I'm Susie Homemaker today. At least I felt like it. I looked in the mirror and I saw this apron, and the Lord goes, why don't you get that on for your show? Life as a Christian, it's for you today. You know, I love having fellowship, and I love talking about Jesus. Is my most favorite thing to do is to share him, be a doer of it, a hearer of it, and share it. You know, I just love it all, because yes, we do have tests and trials, and yes, we have to go through those valleys, and we get on the mountaintop too, and that's a wonderful place to be too, you know. And even in the valleys, you know, Jesus is there. He's going through it with you. He's going through it with you and me. He's going through it with us, you know. And he already did it for us on that cross. He did everything on that cross for you and me. He did it all that day. Every sickness, every disease, every heartache, every hurt. Oh, he did it all for us. That oppression, depression, it's gone in the name of Jesus, you know. He did it. He took it on the cross. Hemorrhoids he took on the cross. Would you believe it? I just found that out recently. Probably months ago now, but it seems like yesterday. But anyway, you know, he took it all on the cross for you and me. He did. He did it for us, you know. It's just a matter of us having that faith. And we do have faith as that little grain of mustard seed. That's all we need. So if you have that faith and your believer comes together, I'm telling you, then you're interlocked and you got it. And Jesus already did it, and you got the promise and you got it. And once that faith and that belief, I'm telling you, it's done in Jesus' name. It's done. It's finished. And yes, the enemy will come back and try to get you in that area, you know. I was healed from a tumor years and years and years ago in 1987, 88. I had this tumor, and they told me I needed to go and have it taken care of. It was going to cost me $1,500. I didn't have the $1,500. I said, okay, God. Either you're going to have to give me the money so I can go to the doctor and have it done, or you heal me. Well, you know, he healed me. I was going through a Holy Ghost prayer line. If you don't know what that is, call me. 727-541-2438. And you call me and talk to me. I'm still learning, just like all of us, you know. We're still learning. But you know what? The Word of God is real. The Word of God is living. It's a living Word. It's not a dead Word. It's not a religion. It's a living Word. Jesus is living in. He's reigning in heaven. I'm telling you, he's coming back here to reign too. So be ready for that day, because he is coming soon. You know, it's just a wonderful thing. And we're going to get together tonight, and we're going to be singing and praising the Lord, bringing in that new year with praise and worship and prayer. So important for us Christians to do that. Get together, have that fellowshipping, and have communion one with another and with our Father and Jesus. You know, we need to have communion daily with them, not just once a year or twice a year or four times a year. We need it daily, a daily fellowship, a daily relationship. Oh, that agape love that only he can give you. But you want that agape love, God's love, that's never ending, and it doesn't get divorced, and it stays forever. It's a wonderful love, and no man or woman really can give us that love. Only Jesus and God can, because they're the author and finisher of it. You know, we don't know how to love like that. Without them, we can't. I know. I've gotten two layers of that love, that agape love. No, it's layer upon layer, line upon line, precept upon, here a little and there a little. We couldn't handle if he gave all of us his agape love. I mean, what he's given me, it's like, wow, overwhelming me, you know? I mean, it really is overwhelming me because I tell you, I could not love a lot of people that he's having me love now in a way that I couldn't love them. I prayed for him and I wanted to love him. Of course I want to love him as God wants me to love him, as a Christian should. But it's hard for us sometimes. Maybe you have that same problem as I do, you know, you have a hard time loving somebody sometimes. But you know what, we can go past all those spirits and see that person and see that heart that God sees and love them because he wants them to be what he created them to be. Now, it's still their choice, but we can pray for them and we can have that agape love. Oh, that only God can give us. That's all I can tell you. Because, I mean, I did not want to watch Ellen DeGeneres. And I know I've shared this with you on another show. But, you know, that spirit of hers, I just wanted to flick her off. Because that spirit, that demonic spirit that is around her, you know, and maybe even in her. But it's on her and around her, okay? And I believe it's in her. And she asked God to forgive her. And she asked them to, you know, God to remove those spirits. They're not going to just go out by themselves. You have to say in the name of Jesus, Father, please help me. I don't want spirits on me. You know, I had spirits. Hey, you know, they still try to get on me, you know. In Jesus' name, we don't have to receive them. And you don't have to have them because they have to go. If you tell them to go, they have to go. And they know that. And like I said, everything has to bow to the name of Jesus. Going to ruin everything. Yeah, they told me that one time. I had demonic spirits in a person that I was around, and they actually told me they wanted to kill me. They said, kill her, kill her, and there was all these different voices, and it was all demonic. But you know what? I had Jesus Christ. I have him living in me, moving in me, and the Holy Spirit in me, and I speak in tongues, and that's what I did, and the Lord showed me one step at a time. It wasn't me. I could not do anything in myself, but it was the Holy Spirit took over, and he did this and told me to do that, and I just step by step, you know, just like a manual when you're learning to put something together. You have to do it one step at a time. Now, it was a scary thing, I guess, but I didn't even think about the fear. I didn't think that even, I wasn't even worried. I figured, I guess I'm so stuck on Jesus, so in love with Jesus and God, that I don't think about those things, you know. Yeah, they could have killed me, but hey, to be absent from this body is to be present with my Lord. And hey, I have nothing to fear. I really don't. I honestly don't have nothing to fear anymore as far as death goes. Now, there was a time when I did fear. Some of you may fear death and may not want to die. But you know what? God is here. He's here for you and he's here for me. So my prayer today is let's bring in the new year with Jesus. Let's bring in the new year praising him, loving him, obeying him, seeking him more with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with everything you have. Seek him more. And you know what? You tell any demonic force to get out of you and to get off of you, and they have to go. In the name of Jesus. Jesus is a powerful name. That's why they don't want us to pray in the Holy Ghost. They don't want to even speak his name because them forces do not want us to have the power. Well, we do, people, and we do, Christians, and it's best that you know now that Jesus is the answer. Sin is our problem, and Jesus Christ is the only answer for you, for me, for all of us. He is the only answer. There is no other answer. But he is the answer for all of us today. So in this new year, let's celebrate him more. Let's love him more. All sickness and disease has to go in the name of Jesus. So be free today. So here I am, Sharon Homemaker, getting prepared for tonight for my prayer fellowship and just praising the Lord. I want to bring in the new year with God Almighty and Jesus Christ. He's the one and only, the one we should always be worshiping. You know, we have stars and we have idols and we have football players that are, you know, our idols and stuff. But you know what? They cannot compare to Jesus. They cannot compare to God. And if you think they are, oh, you're missing it. You're missing it. You're missing the truth. I hope you want the truth today. Seek and you will find. Ask and it will be given. Knock and it will be open. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.